Now you know what you got to do, Vince.
remember yesterday? This is why I get scared, because I am so damn bright.
Yeah.
Do you remember yesterday we were talking about the that libertarians and like we all got together in 1776 and came up with these rules and we all live by them?
Yeah.
So you understood what I said, and you even laughed when I said, what, are we supposed to rewrite the Constitution every time somebody new is born?
Yeah.
So, okay, now you're born right now. Do you agree that old people should get Social Security? Yes or no?
Right.
Okay, we got six over here for yes, two over here. Now, what about, so we all laughed. We thought that was stupid, right?
Yes.
Stupid, right?
Beyond stupid.
Okay, no, no.
Oh, it wasn't.
I got an email or a text or whatever I got from
a letter.
A libertarian.
From a carriage.
A libertarian telling me that Thomas
Is it Ben the Rat?
I won't
By the way, there's another rat who we'll talk about later named Tim Sandifer. Okay. Ooh, we'll talk about that later in the show.
Listen to this. He says that Thomas Jefferson said we should write a new constitution every generation.
Well,
now you see, this is when I tell you, when you really get to know what the libertarians are about, they're little nuts.
Well, that doesn't seem completely unreasonable, Dominic.
Please.
We do make amendments to the Constitution.
Right, but every like, you know, what is it, generation? 10 years?
Well, it's like 20 or 30.
Oh, please, let's change. Okay, now we're taking all the troops and we're making all the troops be gay. And now we're making all the 10 years later, we're making all the troops be women. And now we're making all the, and we're going to pay them. Come on. We have freedom of speech now, but next generation doesn't want freedom of speech. That's out. Take that out of the Constitution.
Well,
this is the libertarian menace I warn you about.
You know, rewriting the entire Constitution, it's a little, you know, outlandish, but, you know, we do change it, and it is a flexible
document.
What
about World War II? They would have put all the Japanese, made them not citizens anymore.
Yeah.
Right? You can't have
But then the next generation, you could be like, remember that whole internment thing? Just kidding. We take it out. My bad.
I love the Constitution, and I got to tell you, I think we're doing pretty damn good here as a country. Unlike you, Vincent, I will say that America is the best country on planet Earth.
You're basing that on, okay, you know what?
Because it's the best.
What are you basing that on? Absolutely nothing. You know what? Okay, hold on, Dominic. Because I actually thought about this. You're saying that based on emotion,
no,
a liberal reaction.
Not at all.
I am saying you cannot make that a qualified statement
not
because
at all.
I'm using logic and thought.
No.
A conservative.
No, not at all.
Go.
Just name any country that's better, that does more, that cares about more, that it has less racism.
1940s Germany.
Than the United States.
Oh.
Costa Rica.
Uganda.
No. They don't. We are the least racist country on planet Earth.
I know.
And you don't know that because you listen to these wackos saying, we're racist.
Europe is so civilized. There's nothing wrong with
it. I tell you, one of my friends, when I was working as a chauffeur, one of my friends was black, and he said to me, he goes, he was from England. Well, he was from Africa, then he was in England. He said, you know, in England, he wasn't allowed in certain restaurants.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, when? Back in 1942? He was only 23 years old.
Yeah.
He said, no, this is about 4 years ago. It still goes on in these other countries. Does it happen here? If somebody black went into a McDonald's and they wouldn't serve him, it'd be on the news, people would be suing, and they would change their policy.